Marshall or the moat?
Boat.
How old do you think these bones are?
How long do you think this guy was buried? You really think that he's on your 15 most wanted list?
That's a boy. Come on, gang. Keep up. Keep up. That's it. That's it.
Hey. Oh. You all right? Yeah?
Marshall!
You all right?
Apparently, I got to hold on to your prisoner till Clearwater Prison figures out a way to squeeze him in.
Well, that should only be about a week or so. I hope it's not too much of an inconvenience.
Well, how would a local police chief go about requesting reimbursement from the federal government for housing in prison?
Now, Captain, I would think you'd consider that a privilege to help the government, considering they gave you the federal funds to build your jail.
Your guy doesn't talk too much.
Well, if you lay down on this table, she'd talk your ear off.
Of course, then you'd be of some interest to me.
But, Judge, it's way muddier down the hill.
Ah, it's plenty good enough right here. Here, hold that for me, will you? Come on, Amy, let me have that bar now. That's it. All right. All set? Okay. Here we go. That's it.
You know, just having an ID and a wallet doesn't mean he's your man.
No, it doesn't, but John Van Adams was wanted on 4 counts of murder and 3 rapes. If this is him, it'll free up a lot of manpower to work on other cases.
How long are you gonna make my life miserable?
Well, if this is the killer, take him off the most wanted list. If it's not, the case stays open. Either way, we'll be out of your hair.
We're on.
How you doing, Amy?
I got 19.
19, huh? Hey. Yeah. That looks farther than the others, huh? Let's count him as 2.
Okay.
Okay? 20 worms at a nickel apiece, huh? So far, you've earned yourself $1, young lady.
Thanks, Judge.
Thank you very much. Nice doing business with you.
Shot at close range, almost point blank.
Okay.
This is not a real man's game, Winston. Real men play gin.
But I never win any money when we play gin.
What is it?
It's an enlargement of the driver's license photo by this guy's wallet. Felton's never seen it.
If what I come up with on the computer looks anything like the photo, I win a 36-ounce porterhouse steak barbecued by himself.
Wow.
Everybody knows you get more worms in the real muddy spots. Here's one. See what I tell you.
Eyes?
Brown?
Hair. Lips and ears are always more problematic.
Hmm. Well, let's see what's behind door number one.
Voila.
It's the same guy.
And I'm cooking.
Sometimes you get the cereal. Sometimes you get the steak.
Captain, we found another one.
Don't crush those bones.
Well, he doesn't care.
I do.
Nathan, get some tape, cordon off this area, and keep these people out of here.
Where's Amy?
Over here. He wandered away from me, I'm sorry.
Are you okay, baby, hmm?
He's been helping me collect worms for my fishing trip.
Found some bones, Mommy. They belong to a real person.
No, honey. Listen, will you go back to town with Judge Tutman while I talk to Captain Hatch? Okay?
Come on, Amy. I happen to know where they've hidden the rainbow sherbet down at Drummond's Five and Dime. Come on.
I have a funny feeling about this one.
Well, come on, let's carry him any time as you
No,
can.
You come on. How do you know it isn't?
This is Winston McBride. He's with the U.S. Marshal Service. Her husband disappeared a few years back, before my time.
7 years this November. Ray Carey?
I got another one over here.
Good Lord.
I almost hope it's Ray. That must sound awful.
No,
It's the not knowing.
Oh, what do you think about all this? Oh, sorry, Tom Masters. I'm the deputy DA.
Winston McBride.
Yeah, I know. It's some kind of serial killer, isn't it?
I don't know, sir. I have no jurisdiction here.
Oh, well, we get maybe one homicide a year here in Tuslip. Sometimes none. We're not exactly experienced in this sort of thing.
Tom, I think I can handle more than just a usual traffic violation. Thank you very much.
Captain? No, what I'm saying is that I'm sure the marshal here, with all his resources, may want to help.
I get paid to chase him, not dig him up. My job is done here, sir.
Maybe I can get forensics to
stay for a couple days. Why don't you give a photograph to the captain here, and Felton will let you know if there's any match between these bodies. I'm heading home.
Jim Pasco, Washington. It's Mr. Somebody Gower.
Yeah.
Is that the name Justin Gower mean anything to you?
No.
Because I'm looking at paperwork that says that you transported him to Clearwater Federal Penitentiary 7 years ago for armed robbery.
I don't remember.
Well, anyway, I've got Justin Gower's remains right here.
So?
Clearwater says he did his 6 years and was released 8 months ago.
What are you getting at, Bill?
The body I'm looking at is a minimum 5 years dead.
Are you sure it's Gower?
Yeah, of course I'm sure. Dental charts and whatnot.
Then who's been in jail for the last 6 years?
Winston. I don't know.
Why would anyone volunteer to go to prison?
Deserves a second chance.
How long's he been gone?
4 days. I haven't had the heart to replace him yet. Hope nothing happened to him. I like Justin. He's a greater tolerance for tedium than any of my other employees. Private. Kind of religious, I guess. Not a lot of earthly possession. Is that one of those x-rays they do of a baby when it's still in the mother?
Yeah. Did Justin ever mention a family to you?
Only time he talked about family was after a few beers at the company picnic. Said he'd like to have one again. A lot of people wouldn't have believed it, but some guys can be rehabilitated. Justin was one of them.
What took you so long?
I'm chasing shadows. What do you got?
The third body, a fellow by the name of Stanley Grant. P.S. All of the deceased were killed by the same kind of weapon, a .38 police special.
Where'd you get this?
Melissa Carey, that's her missing husband.
Does this third man have a criminal record?
No. Why?
Just a hunch. The other two did.
Of course, I only have access to federal files, Winston.
Red, how long has the Two-Slip Police Department been using 38 specials?
Beats me. I've only been here 3 years. I've always had one. Something wrong with the 38?
No, it's a fine close-range weapon.
I think Captain Hatch is pretty fond of them.
Well, you're back.
Found another body in the park.
Which makes four.
Whoever buried those bodies didn't figure on these kind of rains.
Your associate, Felton tells me that the second body, the Justin Gower guy, been dead for 6 or 7 years.
That's right.
Well, I've been thinking. Their rapist disappeared 8 years ago. Gower about 7. Ray, Melissa's husband, hadn't been seen for 7 years. So if one of these bodies isn't his, he could be the suspect.
What do you think, Marshal?
I think the captain's on the right track. U.S. Marshal Service. Can you tell me if a state criminal action has ever been filed against a Stanley Grant?
Is that one of the bodies?
Yes. It's the third one.
I have a Stanley Rumson Grant murder charge, 1986, right here in Two-Slip, but it was dismissed.
All right. How about John Van Adams and Justin Gower? Yes, the first and second bodies.
Body 3's murder charge was dismissed because the police retrieved the murder weapon without a search warrant. They had no other evidence. Body 1 was charged with rape. The action was dropped because the court thought the police conducted a faulty lineup. Body 2 was charged with killing a 16-year-old boy during a convenience store robbery.
Mm-hmm.
and his case was dismissed because the police forced a confession from him before the lawyers showed up.
Makes you sick, these tiny laws, don't it?
Well, nobody's just incompetent unless it's on purpose.
All three bodies had criminal arraignments right here. Same Judge Tutman, same Prosecutor Masters.
You don't think the good people of Tuslip have been taking the law into their own hands, do you?
Don't you just hate it when the good guys turn out to be the bad guys?
Oh, yeah.
Scan this, will you?
Same hair color, same general build. He looked enough like Gower that no one questioned him when he confessed to his armed robbery.
What about fingerprints?
Well, Gower was wanted, but he had no prior conviction, so his fingerprints weren't on record.
Could I have some coffee, please? Is anybody listening to me? Hey, I'm going through withdrawals. I gotta have some caffeine.
Amy!
I'm supposed to get some coffee.
I got an idea. How about if I take you and your mom to the movies this summer?
Coffee, please!
I'll buy you some popcorn.
And a hot dog?
Amy.
Well, no, that's kind of a stiff price. All right, you got a deal. Marshall's waiting in the back for you.
Come on, give me some coffee.
Stay here with Nathan, Amy.
Coffee?
Yeah, in a minute.
Coffee, please!
Rad, you're gonna sit on your sweet butt all day? You're gonna get our guest a cup of coffee, huh?
Take me to Clearwater. I can get coffee there.
Hold your horses, I'm coming.
And make sure it's hot.
Deviant criminal.
Felton constructed the face of this fourth victim. It sort of looks like the photo you gave me. You want to have a look?
That's not him.
Told you, Marshall.
What did your husband do for a living?
He was a bailiff down at the courthouse. Judge Tutman got him a job. The judge looked after Ray. He wanted Ray to go to work. Then go to college. Didn't work out that way.
Yeah, evidently, your Ray got himself a nighttime job.
What does that mean?
Did Ray know Deputy DA Tom Masters?
They all went fishing together. Why are you asking me all this?
What do Tutman and Masters have to do with this? They're good people. I can vouch for them.
You can vouch for them for as long as you've been here, Captain.
Could somebody please explain to me what this is all about?
Melissa, these bodies we've unearthed date back to the time when Ray disappeared. You got to prepare yourself for the possibility that Ray killed these people and then hightailed it.
Ray would never do that. Ray was a good man. If you think Ray killed these people, why did you have me come in and identify him?
I needed to know what you know.
Well, why didn't you just come out and ask me?
I'm a scientist. Deception isn't in my job description.
Captain, where does Tutman live?
Over in Maplewood, but the steelhead are running. He's knee-deep in water now. What we just did wasn't very nice, was it?
No, it wasn't, but unfortunately it was necessary.
Am I done here? Because I have a Jane Doe in Portland. Someone put her through a giant meat grinder.
Yes. Yeah, hook me up with the National Park Service, will you? Get a hold of Masters. Tell him I want to talk to him right away.
You think Ray had help?
Meat grinder.
More coffee, Tommy?
Even decaf's keeping me up nights.
Oh, it's age, honey. I haven't had 4 hours solid sleep in 10 years.
I guess.
See me again.
Ray, I'm somewhat at a disadvantage here.
Stay how you are. We've been wondering where you've been.
I spent the last 7 years paying for my sins by doing somebody else's prison time.
So what do you want?
I want to start fresh. I want my family back again. I want insurance.
Ray, put the gun down. Now, you wouldn't be recording this conversation now, would you, Ray?
I would. I am. We're gonna have a conversation about certain events that occurred 7, 8 years ago.
I don't know what you're talking about.
I knew it. You're gonna blame me for the whole thing. As soon as I read where bodies started turning up, I knew you and the others would just lay all the killings off on me.
Oh, no, Ray, we'll protect you. We'll...
Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against thee in word, deed, and action by what we have done and by what we have left undone.
Ray, listen.
Say how you were involved.
Ray, just let me turn around and then we can talk about this thing rationally, all right? Just take it easy right now.
What are you doing?
Research.
Research? Did you make it to level 3 yet?
Oh, that's funny.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. I thought you were dead. 7 years. Not a word, not a sign.
I had this all figured out. Now I'm just scrambling to make sure my plans aren't completely spoiled.
You've been gone for 7 years.
You don't think I missed you? You don't think my heart cried every day I woke up and thought about you and the baby? Melissa, you have always been in my prayers. But I had to pay for my sins first. I couldn't pick up our baby until my hands were clean.
What are you talking about? Why are you here?
I can still do it. I can still make this work. Promise me you won't tell our baby or anyone you've seen me until this is all over.
Ray.
When it's over.
When what is over?
Promise me, Melissa.
I promise.
Is our baby upstairs? She looks like my mother.
Gary? Is your husband here?
Once again, I don't know what you're talking about, Marshall.
Tom Masters is dead. Your husband may be responsible, and if I were Ray, this is where I'd hide. May I come in?
No. It's late. And Amy's asleep.
Was your husband a religious man?
Only during hunting season and when the Broncos were in the Super Bowl.
Well, he spent the last 7 years in prison serving another man's term, apparently looking for redemption.
Did he find it?
No, he didn't. Now, I'm not going to insult you by asking you if he's been here, because that'd be a federal offense to lie to me, but I am going to ask you to get a hold of me if he shows up. Will you do that?
Did Ray kill those people in the park?
I don't know. All I can do is try to stop him from killing anyone else or being killed himself. At this point, he's a fairly desperate man.
Is there any other kind, Marshall? Ray.
Master's wife died a few years ago. No kids. 25 years of public service ain't a damn person I can call to come pick up his stuff. Just lying cold in a morgue there all alone. Ray Carey did all this, didn't he? Could just explain for me how Tom fits in.
Everybody we found here was charged with a serious crime, but all their cases were dismissed on a legal technicality.
Tom Masters, Judge Tutman were the prosecutor and judge in all four cases.
Yes.
Ray Carey was the bailiff.
Yes. And they were all in custody until their cases were dismissed. A police officer may be involved. I'd like to question everybody that's been here 7 years or longer.
I'm looking for a friend of mine. You seen him?
No.
What's his name? Putnam?
No, it's Tutman. He took out Aloysius to fly fish at Elbow River. You probably remember him from last year. He was fined for shooting a bear out of season.
Oh, Judge Tutman.
Who else has been on the force more than 7 years?
Well, there's Fisher. He's been here forever. And Podowski and Fisher.
That's not a sack of Idaho spuds. Please be careful.
Right. McBride? You rascal. What have you left on my computer?
My. Vanity, thy name is man.
Nathan, you're here early. Dinner's not till 7. What's wrong?
Where's Ray?
Ray?
Come here. I want to show you something. That's blood. I don't see any cuts on you.
Amy cut herself this morning.
Tom Masters is dead. Whoever killed him got hurt in the process.
I don't like being called a liar.
Ray is in trouble.
I can help him. I'm still his friend.
Involved in all this, aren't you?
Melissa.
Don't! Don't!
What I am involved in is justice, protecting innocent people. What did he tell you?
Get out of my house.
Come on, this is me!
Get out!
Supposed to get this far. Well, we're just gonna wait here. He'll be back.
That looks like a campsite over there. Drop me off about a half mile upstream.
Gotta know how to treat them, Judge.
Supposed to be a protective breed.
Dogs have good instinct about people. Who you can trust, who you can't.
Where's it been, Ray? All right?
Throw me the leash.
My heart broke when you ran away. Then when all these bodies start showing up, I figured you were short to follow.
How did you know I wasn't dead?
I was just hoping that you weren't.
I killed Mr. Masters. He was gonna kill me.
Put down that gun, Ray. We're friends.
No. No, I don't think so. Why don't we take a vote on that? All those in favor of Ray putting his gun down, raise your eyebrows. Huh? 2-1, Ray. Put it down. McBride, U.S. Marshal Service.
He's a good boy, Marshal. He's just confused, that's all. Scared and confused.
You the man who dug up the criminals? It's more like I stumbled over him, but the bottom line is here we are. I don't want to hurt you. That's an excellent place to start, Ray.
Now, maybe this is for the best, Ray. Marshal's a lawman, so are we. He can talk to him. And that gun isn't helping.
Stay where you are.
He's as guilty as I am.
I know that, Ray, so why don't you tell me what really happened 7 years ago and we'll get a warrant for the old judge here.
No. No, he talks too good.
You don't want to do this, Ray. Put the gun down.
Hey!
Drop the gun, Marshal. Drop it.
Oh, this is why I don't like chasing the good guys.
Now, pick up the gun, Ray.
You ruined it.
Me in the rain.
God is against me. I don't blame him.
Let's see, you had a judge, a prosecutor, and I'm guessing a police officer on your side. You weren't running from the law, so you must have been running from them.
It was wrong what we were doing, wasn't it?
What did they say?
They said the law was wrong. It got in the way of justice. They said they were gonna take care of me. Help me get into the University of Idaho.
But all you learned about was killing.
first one seems so right. I mean, they found the bloody knife in his motel room. His prints were all over it. Stabbed a girl 15 times with it, but we couldn't use it because the search warrant was bad.
Who was a trigger man, right?
Then the second guy, he never actually got to trial. Judge said it was just gonna get thrown out anyway. Why wait, you know? Last one, it's Justin Gower. He raped a woman behind the grocery store. We just took him out and killed him and blamed it on bad police work afterward.
And you ran.
Yeah, I took Gower's ID and ran. He was already a wanted fugitive. So I just turned myself in. Pay for what I'd done.
And when the bodies started showing up, you could have kept running. But you came back.
It's always been my plan to reclaim my family.
Judge making a phone call?
Going to the bathroom. Be back in a minute.
No, he's not.
Thank you for picking up Amy today, Mrs. Silby. I'll be by later to pick her up. Okay. Bye-bye.
Judge is a smart man. He'll figure a way out of this.
Yeah, real smart. He's probably on the phone right now devising a way to hang my murder on you.
Shut up.
Or better yet, he's probably gonna make it look like we killed each other. Or maybe he's gonna make it look like you killed me, and then the police shoot you.
Shut up, I said.
Well, they'll die in the shootout. You'll get a good collar.
We never planned on killing a federal marshal.
I'll let you in on a legal principle, Nathan. The penalty for killing all the human cockroaches in this world is the same for killing a federal marshal. Be there.
Come on, let's move.
Come on, Ray.
Drop it.
I'm sorry.
Should have listened to me, Ray.
Shut up. Don't hurt her. She's nothing to do with this.
Now she knows too much, Ray. See, that's the trouble with killing. Once you start, it's kind of hard to stop.
Shut up!
Now, you were the shooter, weren't you, Ray? Well, if Ray was the shooter, who's gonna be the shooter now?
I believed in you.
You're a fool if you believe in anyone but yourself.
is Amy? Where's Amy?
A friend picked her up.
We'll go get her and we'll get out of town.
What? Are you crazy? You can't just expect that everything is going to be the same. Things change.
Once you're a family, you're always a family.
You killed four people. How can you be any kind of a father to my child or any kind of husband to me?
Lisa, I can make this work.
I can't, Ring. I can't.
They go over this at Marshall School.
Oh, yeah, in the second week.
Don't you presume to judge us, Marshall. I know what you're thinking. What we did wasn't pretty, but the solution was proper. There's a morality that transcends man's law.
Was that in your oath of office?
You don't know what you're talking about. Your world is black and white. The people you chase are the few the system actually convicted.
The law was your job.
Exactly. But I didn't like to see guilty men walk free.
And you were the final authority.
I was the judge.
That was the problem. Unlock these.
Setting me free.
God is still punishing me. You think he hears our prayers?
Coffee, Nathan?
Thank you.
My pleasure.
Washington said I should give this to you. It's a bill for housing your fugitive. They said to make sure and submit it in your final report.
Thank you.